Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, hello, welcome to my channel, Beauty by Jasmine. And I do want to start by apologizing that my very first video that you ever watch of me, I'm sick, but I can't do anything about it. I've been doing things about to get rid of it, but I actually feel like I'm getting sicker instead of getting better. Honestly, and this video is going to be my 2016 favorites, like of all time, for that year, of course, because you know this year I'm gonna find new makeup that I love, of course. But these are the 2016 favorites, and I honestly feel like I'm getting sicker, so I was like, I'm just gonna record it already. I'm not going to wait until I'm not sick anymore and record it, because what if that's like in the middle of February? Honestly, there was one time that I was sick for like 2 months. So let's jump into this. And the first thing I'm going to talk about are some palettes, you guys, okay? And I have these three palettes, and all three of these I received in subscription boxes. So that's why I love subscription boxes, because you always find items that you fall in love with. So I'm going to talk about these two over here first. And honestly, these kind of look, these are the Studio Makeup On The Go eyeshadow palettes. And these remind me of the Kylie Jenner palettes. They are just so beautiful. I have used them on my channel on Get Ready With Me. That's what I was saying. And look at these, you guys. They are so beautiful. This one is like warm tone. This one's cool tone. I think that's what they're called. Exactly, most likely. Does it even have the name? I don't think it does. This one says warm up. And this one says cool down. So, yeah. And this one looks like the warm, like her first palette, and this one a little bit like the burgundy palette, not that much, you know. But I love these. You can tell I have been using them, but I love these because they are so pigmented, so easy to blend, and so long lasting, you guys. I'm in love with them. I am so happy that I got them in my boxes. Okay. And, you know, that girl's still gonna get my money. I still want Kylie Jenner's palettes. If only she could restock it and it stays in stock for a while. You know. I'm so glad she opened up a store. Maybe I could just go to her freaking store and purchase all the palettes I want instead of having to wait for them to be online. But I got these. They're so amazing. All right. And I do not have any palettes that I have purchased on my own, because I just haven't purchased any palettes. I've been wanting to, but palettes are like expensive, the most expensive thing ever, like $50. And I didn't have a job. Now that I have a job, hopefully I can start purchasing all the palettes that I want. Or if not, hopefully I can start like saving up money. Like $20 every time, like I can, and I'll have a palette in like a month. I'll purchase a new palette every month, you know, if I do that. So those, I got those to show you. And then I got this little one also in a BoxyCharm, and it is by EBY Beauty. And this brand, you guys, is amazing. They're so This one actually has a mirror, unlike those, so I love that, because if I ever need to take this with me and touch up, or if I'm ever going to like go stay over at my sister's house, I need that mirror. And honestly, you guys have seen me in my Get Readies with me. Sometimes I do my mirror with a little mirror like this. And anyways, but this one, this palette has your three shades that everybody uses. I use these all the time. I use that white to set my eyeshadow base, the gold all over my lid, and then the brown in my crease. And then And sometimes that's all I use. Sometimes I could go into like another palette and smoke it out, but this is really all I use sometimes, you guys. Honestly. Okay? But, you know, now that I look at it, now that I have advanced in my makeup skills, I do use more colors, like to highlight the bone, to smoke out the bottom lash line. But this is a very good palette to keep in your purse because the colors that usually fade away are the ones that are all over your eyelid and in the crease. Those are the ones that I tend to seem to find that fade away. But this one is very awesome and very, very pigmented. Pigmented. Let me show you. Let me show you that I'm not shitting you, okay? Look at that, and then look at this. How do I show this? Oh, not, don't want to show my flab, but look at those, okay? So I'm not lying. I'm honestly not lying. All right, next thing I see is a highlight. Do I have another one, or do I just have one? Oh, I have one over here. I actually have three. So I have these three highlights. This one is in another category though. But I have been loving the Revolution, Makeup Revolution London Pro Illuminates. These are so beautiful. I mean, you guys have seen me use these so many times. But let me just swatch it. Look at that. Gosh, these are so beautiful. And then I recently discovered this one in like November from a Sweet Sparkle subscription box that I unsubscribed to, but I'm gonna get it back because I feel like I get a lot of views on those videos since it is a new subscription box and everybody wants to know about it. So I'm gonna get that box back. I am because I was liking it too. But just not the month of November. I didn't like that month, which is why I didn't do a get ready with me with using the products. But I did receive this in the Sweet Sparkle box. It is drugstore, but these are highly, highly pigmented. And they honestly remind me a lot of the Makeup Geek and Kathleen Lights collection that I'm still gonna get it, you know. I'm not like, you know, since I have this, I'm not gonna get it. I'm still gonna get it. But that was the middle shade right here. Do you see this? And this is the first shade. And then the last shade that's over here. That one came up a little chalky because my hand is so dry right there, but look how pigmented that is. And that other one as well. I was loving this ever since I got it in 2016. I'm probably gonna be using it even more in 2017, and I'm probably gonna have to repurchase it because I love it. I've been using this since like August, and I haven't even had to repurchase it. I haven't made a dent in it. These are good. These have a bunch of product in it. They don't even have a whole ounce in it. They have half an ounce. But you don't use highlight a lot, especially when they're that pigmented. And those are my favorite type of highlights. This next one is in, by the brand Vintage. This one was by the brand City Colors. You guys, being stupid, it is the highlight trio. All right, but this one is by the brand Vintage by Jessica Limbreskid. And I did put this in a disappointing products video one time because I did not like how it wasn't pigmented and how powdery it was as well. But look at that, it actually is kind of pigmented. I don't know. I probably didn't give it as much of a try, but I honestly have been using this as a blush topper on top of my matte blushes, and it makes them look so beautiful. It gives them it was giving it such like a subtle glow, but you know, I have also been noticing that maybe it was a brush that I was using, maybe it was not grabbing enough product. So that's probably why, because I have been seeing, you know, we're getting one of these in the January BoxyCharm for, you know, but it is a duo one, and we're also getting a fan brush, and people have been putting it on with the fan brush, and they look so pigmented, but I was putting it on with, like, a stippled brush, and I'm like, no, I don't like this. So I'm going to give this a try with a fan brush and hope maybe I will like it as a highlight. I need to see. But I have been loving this as a blush topper, you guys. Okay? Okay. And there is one last highlight. I got this in the December box. In a December box. Actually, in a winter box. And it was the Beautycon BFF box that it is still available if you guys want it. I believe, I don't think it has sold out, but I got this in that box. It is the Artist Contour highlights in the shade Illuminati. You guys, this is what I call a highlight. This is what I call a highlight. I don't like subtle highlights. Look at that. I don't like subtle highlights. I want them to blind you and look. That's blinding. That's the brightest one out of all of them. I put it on my cheeks and it's like I threw a big ass ball on my cheeks of glitter. And I have to really blend it out or else I'm gonna look cray cray. So I'm loving these. I'm gonna purchase more of these actually. You know, I'm gonna purchase that $100 box that is there that has 12 of these because that's how much I love them and I want to try more of them. So you need to try this. You need this in your life, honestly. If you haven't tried these, try them. These are the best ones out of all. I do not like that they're loose highlights. I find that they make a mess, but after you're done making a mess, they are so beautiful. Honestly, I used that one day and my husband came in the room. He's like, why is there so much glitter in the air? I was like, I gotta highlight that face, guy. Gotta highlight that face, boy. So don't trip. This next thing is a shimmer bronzer. It's a radiant shimmer bronzer by the brand Hikara Cosmetics. And this is like, it has highlights and the bronzer and the blush. And I like to roll it all together and use it as a blush. That's what I like to do. So let's just roll it and swatch. It makes like that brownish, nudie color. That's why I love it. Look at that. This is perfect for medium skin tones, but for light skin tones, you could really blend it out, and it works perfectly as well because I'm a light skin tone and I like wearing it. Well, I was wearing it in the summer though. I wasn't wearing it much in the winter. I was wearing this baby in the summer a lot. So pigmented and shiny, I love it. And then we have this bronzer over here. You know this bronzer. You guys know this bronzer if you've been following me on my channel for a while. This is a Revolution Makeup Revolution London Ultra Bronzer. And this one is so perfect for the summer. It's okay in the winter as well if you add it to your face and get a clean brush and blend it out. Stupid fly. Alright, it's okay for that too. But It is perfect for the summer because it is dark. It is like a very cool tone one. It is also perfect for contour. If you do contour, this is perfect and it's only $7. Only $7. Oh, there's another highlight right there. And then I have the butter bronzer. And this is like for the medium skin tone, it says, because they did come up with a light shader, like a lighter shade. Was dusty. It was so powdery. I love how it smells so much, but this one's lighter than that one. Smells so good. And it used to give me a headache, but I'm used to it now. It doesn't give me a headache anymore. I could apply it to my face and I don't get headaches anymore. And I love it, you guys. Love it. All right, and then another bronzer I have is the Too Faced. My voice, it cracked so much. The Chocolate Soleil for medium or deep skin tones. I like to use it as a bronzer and add it with a brush and then blend it out with a clean brush. I like to do that with this one and with the Ultra Bronzer as well. But look at this. This is so perfect as well for contouring. Oh my gosh, you guys. All three of those would be good for contouring though. But look at that. You can tell what kind of bronzers I'm in love with. And I bronze my face like that, and I want them to be matte on my cheeks, but then I take a highlight and I highlight right here and I highlight up here, and it's so beautiful. I highlight on top of the bronzer and it's beautiful. I think that's the last bronzer, but I did seem to forget a highlight. And the highlight that I forgot was the Laura Geller New York in the shade Baked Gelato Swirl. So this is an illuminator. And it looks like this. It's very cold. I got this in December, but ever since I got it, I'm like, where the hell were you? I needed you all my life. You know, all the products that I'm mentioning that I got in December were like that. So it is right here. It kind of looks like the artist contour, but a little golden either. Or this one looks like a pinky gold. This one looks like a gold. I don't know, but look at my hand. I love everything. All right, so then blushes. I have some Wet n Wild blushes that I have been loving because these are like $4 and they last all day and they're so pretty. So I have the shade Apricot in the Middle that I got in a Sweet Sparkle box, and Kathleen Lights is in love with it, so I wanted to try it. So happy I didn't have to pay for it. I'm just joking. I'm so happy I received it though, because I honestly had forgotten about it and then I received it. I was like, oh my gosh, I have been wanting to try this. And then I went and bought more. So Apricot in the Middle and Pearlescent Pink. I do have more, but I haven't been using them. I've been using these two. All right. I still haven't even tried them, honestly. But Apricot in the Middle is this very peachy shade. Do I have some clean fingers? Gosh. Not really. Hopefully it doesn't mix. But that one is Apricot in the Middle. Oh my gosh. I should do another. I didn't get enough product. There we go. Look at that. I'm in love with that. And then this is Pearlescent Pink, and this one's just like a very light pink. My all-time go-to shades throughout the whole year. The only time I use like a little bright pink is summer and spring, and I use light pinks and peachy tones and nudie tones all year long. I have a lot of blushes in here, though. All right, so this is Pearls in Pink. These are the Wet n Wild Color Icon blushes. Didn't mention that. But look at that. That's Pearls in Pink. That's bright when you swatch it, but it could really work for the winter. It's really, you can make it light. I have one of the Revolution London Big Blushes, and it's the shade All I Think About Is You, and I love this one way too much, you guys. This is like it you could feel an indent in it. It hasn't like seen like pan yet, but this is the one I used a lot, and it is like a purplish pink shade. I should probably swatch it down there so you guys can see even better. There we go. I'm in love. All right, and then three more blushes on this side. They're all Laura Geller ones. I got two mini ones and one big ass one. The big one is, these are Baked Blush and Brightens because they have like bronzer in them. They're like shimmery with a lot of powder. Chick up that I didn't clean off last time I used it, I guess. But this one is like a very light pink. Running out of room to swatch. That's a very light pink. Love it. Love, love, love. You can tell which colors I like. I don't like bright in your face colors that much. Even in the summer, like I tend to not use them that much, but I use them more still. Because in the winter I would never use them, and if I use it like two times in the summer, that's more to me. So this next one is called Pink Grapefruit, and this one is more goldeny than pink because it has more bronzer in it than blush. You just roll that all together, and there it is. It's a very nude color. All about those nudes. And the last one is in the shade Pink Buttercream. And it's just like the other one, where it kind of, I mean, do you see this? It has like, I don't know. This one has less bronzer. Excuse me. Less bronzer than that one does, but this one still has more than this one does. Alright, they're kind of the same. They're kind of the same, but they're, I don't know, they make them look different. Tones. You see? They're all different. They're all beautiful. I'm in love with all of them. Alright, so what's next? I forgot to mention these with eyeshadow, but I wasn't even going in order anyways. Oh, this one fell out of the pan. So these are the NYX eyeshadows. These are the single eyeshadows that I was loving this year. I don't really tend to use a bunch of single eyeshadows anymore, but these are the ones that I have been loving a lot. And all of these kind of fell out of the pan. That's weird. But this one is in the shade, the one I swatched is in the shade Valetti, and this blue one is in the shade Blue Jeans. But these are the ones that I have been loving for single eyeshadows. And then I have Punk Heart. I have one of these, well, not just one. These are not all my NYX eyeshadows, single eyeshadows, you guys, but got Pink Cloud. Another Blue Jeans, but this one's different. I remember this one was lighter. They just gave it the same name. And then Mermaid. So the NYX ones are the ones that I have been loving this year for for single eyeshadows. I tried the Sephora ones as well. I really love the NYX ones more than the Sephora ones. These are the bomb diggity. All right, moving on. I seem to have forgotten a highlight. And this is the Baked by Dirty Little Secrets highlight in the shade Sun-Kissed. Sun-Kissed, like the soda. But it is a very gold shade. I really want to get that on my finger. Put it right here. Look at that. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. So amazing. I just have so many highlights and blushes in here because those are what I love the most. I don't know. And eyeshadow, because you know you could create so many colorful, cute looks with them. And the lip products are the best, the number one, you know. But anyways, I loved this mirror this year. I need to get more, still haven't. They're only $5. And they're double-ended from NYX. So go get you one. I loved these e.l.f. This is the drugstore lipsticks that I loved. Okay, this for 2016. And I have all of them. I have them all. Okay. Okay, I have doubles of some, an accident, actually, and that's those the ones I have double are in my giveaway pile though. But I have all of them. I don't think I have all of them in my hands, but I do have all of them mostly. Well, I think I'm missing like one or two, but I have all of them. I have Rich Red, Wine, Scarlet Night, Pearlene, Dash of Pink, Berry Sherbet, Tea Rose, and Natural. These are awesome. Let me swatch some. This one is Natural. Ooh, that's beautiful. And then this one's Berry Sherbet. I knew it. I was like, which one is this? I already know the names of them and everything. Alright, so I'm gonna leave some room for other things. But those are amazing. Okay, here's another one. This one is in the shade Cranberry. I don't know, you guys. These are just the lipsticks from the drugstore that I love this year for only $3. You do have to reapply them, but honestly, sometimes I take them off to eat and then reapply them anyways. Oops. There's a few things in here that I'm not going to mention because they're just in here an accident. But nail polishes that I love this year. This is my favorite top coat that I found in 2016 of all time. It is the Big Matte Top Coat by Sally Hansen. And it just makes your nails look super matte. And it does not take off for like a week. I love it. And then I found this brand through BoxyCharm. And I'm in love with them. They last like 5 days before they start shipping. I'm in love with them. And then going down in prices, Essie is another brand that I discovered this year that I'm in love with so much. And then this is my favorite brand of all time. I think my sister told me about these in 2015, but in 2016 Kylie Jenner made her brand, and they're matte, and I love them. I love all Sally Hansen nail polishes, and especially the Kylie Jenner ones. Oh my gosh, much. I'm in love with them. I wish I had all of them because I love them all. So that's it in this box. I'm not going to start putting everything away because that's going to take up time. Over here, we have a few things to go over left. Alright, so I discovered this in 2016, and I have been saying that I want to try out more powders, but I haven't because I'm like so in love with this one. And it is the NYX Mineral Set It, Don't Fret It Matte Finishing Powder in the shade Light Medium. I don't do foundation at all right now, but I do my concealer. I don't have a favorite concealer. I did not find a concealer that I love in 2016. I was using concealer just to use it so that I wasn't wasteful and threw it away. But, and because I did not have money to buy a new one that I actually loved. But I did love this. It made any concealer, even if I didn't love it, look the bomb. So that is, this is the bomb. This is the bomb. Like, I would put on the concealer and I would blend it out, and I would still see a little bit of my dark circles seeping through. And then I would put this on top. The dark circles were gone. This is amazing. This is the amazing full coverage setting powder. I love it. I need more of those, but I also need to try other ones since I'm trying to be a beauty vlogger influencer. I need to try other ones and let you guys know whether I like them or not, but I love that one. I also discovered this NYX eyeshadow base in 2016, and it is white. It is white, and I love it. Like, it makes your eyeshadows go on so smooth, stay on longer, because I used to not use an eyeshadow base, and my eyeshadows would suck. They would look so bad, and now they look so bright and so pretty with this, and I'm amazed. I need to try other ones, of course, because this is the only one I have tried, but I'm in love with this one, and it's only $6, so if you're on a budget, you should try this, and this is only $10. Those are lips. So, mascara, you guys. I have been loving this for the base. It is a Voluminous. It's L'Oreal Paris Voluminous Base, but it is white. It is a white primer for your eyelashes. But I'm in love with it because I was using one by Benefit, the tinted one, and it would make them look longer. But this one makes them look longer and it just makes them look like if you have fake eyelashes on. Like, it makes them look longer and thicker. There we go. Longer and thicker, and the Benefit one was only making them look longer, so they kind of felt like they looked like spider and more natural. This one does not make you look natural. This one makes you look like you have fake eyelashes on, and I love that because I don't like fake eyelashes. I never think I would ever wear those, but I love this. I really do like this mascara that I have been trying for like the past 3 months. For the past 2 months, maybe, by the makeup eraser, the Amplic mascara. And then the other mascara that I have been loving, but I do not have, so I'm gonna pull up a picture, is the Rimmel London Scandal Eyes Retro Glam Mascara. It looks like this. I was using the waterproof one for about 5 or 6 years, and then I was like, you know what? I'm not really liking this waterproof one anymore because it is so hard to take off. Like, when I take it off, I pull off a bunch of my lashes. So I need to find one that's not waterproof. And I saw that the same brand made it. The same They made this in 2016. The same mascara, but not waterproof. It's like, I'm going to try it. So I bought it. I tried it. I fell in love with it. I bought two of them, I think, and I used up the two of them. And then I didn't purchase it anymore because I kept getting mascaras in the subscription boxes. And I was trying those out. I got this in a BoxyCharm. I got the base in a Target box and in the Beautycon BFF box. I have two of those. I've been getting them in beauty boxes. So I was like, I'm not going to purchase it. I'm going to save my money. And I was like trying to save money. Like I had no money to buy makeup anyways. But I'm going to repurchase this because this is my favorite mascara of all time. My sister just purchased me a Better Than Sex mascara. And they say, I've heard people say that this is a dupe for it. This is only $8 and the sample of the Better Than Sex is $12. So I need this back in my life. I really do. Alright, so that's it for mascara. So now, lashes, the heck, eyebrows. I discovered these two eyebrow pencils this year. One is by Dolce Cosmetics and the other one is by e.l.f. And I got this one in a glossy box, but I really do like it. And then I got this one at the store and I have repurchased this already like 5 times. And I'm in love with this one. I like this one a little bit more than this one, but I'm going to use this one up because I have it. And I really like that this one is only like $2. You know what I mean? All right. And then a brow gel that I like is the, I don't have it, but it's the, a brow gel that I love, I have to say. It's a clear one by, I can't even remember the name of it. Gosh. I honestly can't remember the name. I'll leave it down in the description box. If I remember the name of it, like I'll type it in what it was because I can't seem to remember the name. And then I have been using this one for like the past 2 months, a retro brow, but I only like the gel side. I don't like the fiber side, so I will not repurchase this again because it's $30. Oh, it's the Brow Gal. It's the clear gal by the Brow Gal. That one is amazing. That one's $20 and it is amazing. This one is $30. I like the gel. But I don't like the fiber gels, and I love the Brow Gal. That one was amazing. But I only like, I don't love, so I won't repurchase it. But I kind of wanted to mention it because I don't know, I just wanted to mention it. I don't know, probably shouldn't have because I'm not in love with it. I discovered some eyeshadow sticks this year. And they are the Lorac Loves Tati. Lorac. No, the LOC Loves Tati. The Love in Color and Tati collection. And I am in love with these shadow sticks. I have the shade Daytrip and the shade Impress Me in my hands. Because these are the ones I was using the most this year. Although I have other shades of them. But I really do love these shadow creams and shadow sticks for my lazy days where I'm like, I'm going to do a full face of makeup, but I don't want to mess with the eyeshadow. So I'm just going to pop this all over my lid and that's it. And that's what I was doing with these. And I would put this one all over my eyelid and then I would put this one in the inner corner and I was done. That was it. And I have recently bought in a bunch of the NYX Roll, like the Roll Shimmer ones. And I haven't tried them yet, but I'm excited. Like, they are super good on your hands. And all of the people that work at NYX say that they love them for different reasons. One of them told me to try them out all over my eyelid with a NYX glitter glue, and that's going to make them stay all day and make them really pop. And then the guy that works there told me that he loves to use it on top of his blush to give it a pop of shimmer. So I'm going to try both ways out. But honestly, I just hauled them and said I was going to do a swatch video of them. But I want to get the four shades that I'm missing first. And then I'm going to use them. And I'll do a review and swatch video of them because I think they're new. I think they just came out in 2017, you guys. Or 2016, but I didn't find them. But I did find these in 2016, and I love them. And I did find other cream shadows, but I forgot to put them in here. But cream shadows this year, I discovered, and I love them because I'm like the type of girl that I'm like, I don't want to mess with my eyeshadow, so I'm not going to do it. Now I could be the type of girl that I don't want to mess with my eyeshadow. I don't want to have to do all that blend, blend, blend stuff. So just pop this all over your lid and run out the door after you do everything else, of course. Beauty blenders. Okay. One of them, this one over here. I love it, but it is a drugstore brand, and I don't know what brand it is. I did get it in a sweet sparkle box, so I unboxed it, so I could look up, like, if I ever want to purchase it, I could go and look to see what brand it is. But over here on this side, this one is a Morphe sponge, and I love it. And I love that it's pink because I go to the Morphe website and all they have is the red, and I don't want the red. I feel like when you wash the red ones, the dye comes out, and I don't want that on my face because, you know, I use them damp. So what if the chemicals are going inside my face because it's damp? So I don't want the red ones. I want pink. So I love those. Hopefully Morphe catches up with the game and makes other colors and not just the red one. Alright, we're almost done. Eyeliners. I have been loving this NYC eyeliner for years. As long as I was loving that waterproof one, I was loving this NYC one. But this is the NYC City Proof 24-Hour Mascara, and I was loving it in black. But I recently accidentally purchased it in brown, and I also love it in the brown one. This one is the brown one, and I discovered it this year, and I'm in love with it. I love you, and I love your friend too, the black one. Okay, and then the last eyeliner that I have that I discovered in 2016 is the Rimmel London Scandal Eyes Waterproof Kohl Kalaya, I don't know, but it is a black one. It is in the shade 001 black, and I wanted to try this out because I love the mascara. So I was like, I want to try out the eyeliner. I love it too. I love it too. I have a problem with my eyeliners that no matter what eyeliner it is, in like 5 hours, it seems to have faded out of my waterline in a couple places, and I need to like reapply it. But that is all eyeliners. I haven't discovered even one eyeliner that does not do that. And these two do that, but I think that's just because it's like in your waterline and it's like watery right there. So I don't know. But I have discovered these two eyeliners for 2016. And I love them so much. And the brown one kind of made me feel like I need to test out more colorful eyeliners and put some pop in my eyes. Okay, so now very last thing I have for you guys, get away, are lip products. And I don't have much, but I have some. I have four brands and four lipsticks. Well, five brands, okay? Okay. The first one I got in the December beauty box, Boxycharm, and it is the Ofra Metallic Liquid Lipsticks in the shade Napa Valley. I need all of them. I need all the rest that they have in this metallic shade, because this one is the best. This one's the bomb. Diggity. Look at that. I'm in love with this Ofra one. I just really need to get a job though, because each of these are $20. And I want them. I want the Too Faced ones too, but I don't have any at all. So I can't talk about those whether I like them or not. But this one, I have tried this, like this metallic shade. And I have also tried a normal liquid lipstick that I don't have anymore because it finished. And I love the Ofra liquid lipsticks. I love all liquid lipsticks. Those are my favorite. But I love them. I love that brand. All right. The next one is from Julep. These Julep ones, this is the only shade I have tried. But I do like it. This one is a little creamy. It's like, it's a liquid lipstick that stays creamy. So it does seem to get in my teeth a little bit. Not as much as regular cream lipsticks, but it does seem to get in my lips, teeth a little bit. But I like them. I like these lipsticks. I'm going to try out all the other shades I have and probably buy more, because I'm okay with like swiping the lipstick out of my teeth like one or two times a day, but not like 10 times a day. So I like that. I like these. And then we have by another liquid lipsticks by the shade, by the brand Bella Pierre, and this is the Kiss Proof Lip Cream in the shade Antique Pink. And these are, people are saying that these are so drying. I don't find them. Excuse me. My throat just got so itchy. But I don't find these drying, you guys. Liquid lipsticks and matte lipsticks are my favorite. I can't do cream. I can't do cream, so I love these. Alright. So if you're like me, that you love liquid lipsticks and matte lipsticks only, but you're afraid to try them because people are saying they're drying. I think my kids are waking up. Because people are saying they're drying. Just go ahead and try this brand, Bella Pierre. I want to buy more of these. But I think these are also like in the $20 price range. And I did also get this one in a BoxyCharm. That is why I love subscription boxes. Who could survive? My throat is a little itchy. The next one is from the brand ColourPop. And this is a lippy stick. And I have not tried ColourPop at all, but I really did like this shade. It is the shade BeautyCon, because I got it in that BeautyCon subscription box. But I did like that nudie pink shade. And I also like that it's cream, but it doesn't get in your teeth. So this is probably going to be like the only cream lipsticks that I will ever wear. I need to buy more. They're only $5. I need to buy more. And I need to buy all the matte ones and the liquid lipstick. I need to buy everything on that website. Okay? Alright, and then the last thing is by a brand called Luna, and this is a lip gloss in the shade Titania. This one's so beautiful. I wish I could put it on my lips and swatch it for you guys, but I'm sick. Don't want to contaminate it. But it is very metallic. Look at this. I love it. And it doesn't get in my teeth either, so I love it. My eye got a little watery for coughing. All right. But that is everything that I discovered in 2016 and fell in love with. It was so much, and it was only like 5 months. So maybe for next year, I'm probably going to split it up because this video is 50 minutes long. So maybe for next year, if I discover a lot more products, I'll probably like split it up into sections. But that is going to be everything that I have for you guys in this video. I hope you guys enjoy that it was a long video. I know some people like long videos, and some people don't. I personally do like long videos. But that's gonna be everything that I have for this video. And if you're new, hello, welcome. In the description box, I always leave the link to some of my past videos just in case you're interested in checking out other past videos where I'm not talking all scratchy, hopefully. And I also leave down the links to my social media just in case you want to come and see what I'm up to when I'm not on camera. But yeah, that is going to be it. And I do recommend everything, you guys, okay? And nothing is sponsored. Like I did mention BoxyCharm a couple times, but it's not sponsored, okay? But thank you guys so much for watching, and I'm gonna see you guys in another video very, very soon. Bye, guys.